France's Notre Dame Cathedral has endured for more than 850 years, through the Middle Ages, the French Revolution, and two world wars. It's played roles in history, literature, architecture, and even a Disney movie. But along with all that, one of the things that makes this place so unique is its sound. From its bell towers to its massive pipe organ to the echo of every footstep and whisper inside the building, Notre Dame has long been known for the way sound moves within its space. So a lot was at stake when a fire broke out in 2019. And without the work of hundreds of architects, engineers, builders, and physicists, much of Notre Dame's iconic sound may have been lost to history. Notre Dame's sound is unique because, well, sound in every space is unique. Acoustics is a science that deals specifically with the physics of sound, but acoustics can also refer to things like the materials and structures that make up a building. Things like wood, stone, carpet, the shape of the ceiling, and the position of benches or columns can all shape the way things sound. And even small changes to these materials and structures can change the way things sound in that space. Sound travels through the air in waves. When you do something like strum a guitar or hit a drum, it makes a vibration. And that vibration makes the air molecules around the instrument vibrate. And as those molecules vibrate, they bump into more molecules and make them vibrate, and on, creating what's known as a longitudinal sound wave, which allows sound to travel from the instrument to your ear. Along the way, these waves can interact with the materials and structure of a space. They might bounce off hard surfaces like stone, or be absorbed by softer surfaces like carpet. In a small space, it doesn't take long for sound to bounce off the walls and back to your ears. But in a larger space, there are a lot more places for the sound to go. So one way to measure acoustics is to measure reverberation time, or how long it takes before we can no longer hear reflected sound in a space. We measure that by seeing how long it takes a specific sound, known as an impulse source, to fade away. And in Notre Dame, with its high ceilings, marble floors, plenty of wood and limestone, plus some iron and lead, remember, it was the Middle Ages, there's lots of space for sound waves to move through and lots of stuff for them to bounce off of without being absorbed. On average, sound hangs around in Notre Dame's air for 6 seconds. We know that because of Dr. Brian Katz, an expert in acoustics who has spent more than a decade studying Notre Dame sound. Katz published a series of acoustic measurements taken throughout the cathedral. Before his work, there was very little consistent or reliable data documenting the building's acoustics. So Katz's team placed specialized equipment throughout the cathedral, including 12-sided loudspeakers and omnidirectional microphones to capture and measure differences in sound in different parts of the building. Then they conducted a series of tests to measure reverb in the cathedral. Different pitches produce sound waves that may be closer or farther apart and can move around a space in different ways. So they used the swept sine method, sending out audio signals at different frequencies using loudspeakers and recording the reverberation with microphones. They also did balloon bursts, literally popping a balloon, in different spots around the cathedral and measuring the sound. Katz used all his data to create digital models of Notre Dame that could simulate how music would sound in different parts of the cathedral, and what would change if Notre Dame's materials or structures were different. Which brings us back to 2019, when things in Notre Dame changed a lot. Shortly after the fire, French President Emmanuel Macron announced that Notre Dame would be completely restored. And since Katz was the only one who had measurements of the acoustics, his research would become a crucial part of the rebuild. In 2020, as work was underway to make the building stable for workers to begin the restoration project, Katz's team was allowed back into Notre Dame to conduct more tests. This time, it wasn't safe just to walk in with a bunch of mics. So remote-controlled robots pulled equipment throughout the building. And when they compared the 2020 numbers to the data from 2015, the results were pretty stark. Notre Dame was 20% less reverberant than it had been before the fire. Katz used the data and models to consult with those working on the rebuild and show how the sound would change if they did things like adding more glass to the structure. One proposal suggested moving the organ to a different location that would be more visible. but the digital model suggested the organ sound couldn't carry throughout the building as well, so they left the organ where it was. In December 2024, Notre Dame reopened to the public. Soon after, Katz and his team began the work to take new measurements of the space. Even before analysis of the data was complete, Katz expected that the cathedral might be even more reverberant than it was before the fire. That's partly because the organ pipes and limestone were cleaned, and the carpet that was installed in the 1980s was removed, leaving more exposed marble. For a place like Notre Dame, no one expects things to remain unchanged for more than 850 years. But thanks to Katz's work, we now have a clearer sense of how the cathedral once sounded, a fuller appreciation of its acoustics today, and the knowledge to preserve this living history of art, architecture, and reverberant sound for generations to come.